Hey, good morning, everybody. Today is Saturday, I think October 29th, and I'm coming at you from getmyfreebedbugreport.com. Anyway, something fascinating is happening today. It's actually snowing. I think it's pretty cool. But what's not fascinating is it's starting to get very cold out. And with that, you may have an influctuation of bed bugs. Let me explain why. People are going to start to wear their winter jackets, and their actual winter jackets are going to intermingle with other winter jackets. And whether you are going to work or your kids are going to school, there is a possibility, a likelihood, that some of those jackets are going to intermingle, are going to have bed bugs. And what's going to happen is there's going to be a transferability effect, in which, in fact, you are going to bring bed bugs home, or your kids are going to bring bed bugs home, and you're going to end up with a bed bug problem. So I'd like to give you some pointers that you can use regardless of where you are around the country as you're watching this video. Number one, you want to assume that you're going to have bed bugs. And I know it's kind of a horrific idea to have in your head, but you want to assume that. And so then you can take the following precautions. Number one, when your kids come home from school, you want to get an allocated area in which they're going to put their jackets and they're going to put their book bags. It's not a good idea to have them throw it over the couch and take their book bags and throw it on the floor. And unfortunately, these are the times that we live in today. So we do have to make changes whether you want to or not. And if you think you're never going to get bed bugs, you may be foolishly mistaken. And so my goal is to help you to kind of avoid having that problem. So you want to allocate an area in which they can put their jackets inside a particular container, or teach them how to use the dryer. If they come home and they take their jacket and they throw it in the dryer for about 20 minutes on high heat, that would kill every stage of bed bugs as well as also the eggs. You can also do that with book bags. Once a week, take everything out of your kids' book bags and you can put it on high heat. If your kids have some kind of plastic book bags that may melt, of course, that's not going to be a good idea. At that particular point, you can pick up something from our website store at www.pestplus.net/catalog. You can pick up some Nuvi strips, and what that is, you can put that in a container. There is no heat involved. You leave that in overnight, and that would also kill every stage of bed bugs as well as also the eggs. And for yourself, if you're going to work, again, you don't want your jackets or your clothes or your pocketbooks to intermingle with other people's garments that may be bringing bed bugs home from their own house. So if you are, when you do come home, you either A, you want to take your garments also and throw it in the dryer in high heat. Listen, again, this is a different era that we're living in. When me and my wife and my kids, we go to the movies, we come home, we put all our stuff in the dryer. We're not going to take a chance of bringing something home from the movie theater and putting it in our house and having a bed bug infestation. So you want to learn to put your garments in the dryer in high heat for about 20 minutes. That'll kill every stage. If you do have leather garments or pocketbooks and you are concerned, you have several options. Number one, you can still put it in the dryer, but you have to use low heat, of course, so you don't melt or damage any of your garments. Number two, you can avoid that if, again, you go and you get a container and you get some Nuvi strips and you put the Nuvi strips inside that container and let that go overnight. And by the next morning, if you did have bed bugs in there, any stages of a bed bug, including the eggs, that would kill it. Number two, when you do go to work, is if you can bring some kind of little kind of carry case that you can put your garments in there as well as also your pocketbooks, rather than hang it up with everybody else's stuff, you have a less likely chance of picking up bed bugs. And then you can just put that little case that you're going to use, whether it be a gym bag or something a little bit bigger, in the dryer once a week, just to add that precaution of not bringing bed bugs home. It is very common that people are going to work. Again, you have different cultures and different people. Some cultures believe that you shouldn't kill any kind of bugs, and some cultures, it's not really a big deal to them. And so you want to make sure that you understand it's going to be a big deal to you. This goes with your pocketbooks. Another thing is you want to do is, if you don't want to do that or you can't do that, you can pick up a garment bag. They sell these garment bags whether you go to Nordstrom's or other places. And you can actually put your jacket, sweater, pocketbooks in a garment bag, and then you can hang that on a hanger. And at least that will you'll have allocate you'll ha it'll be allocated to a particular area, and you won't have that much of a problem of being in Breadbug's home. Remember, the season has now changed. People are traveling with their jackets, whether they're traveling on the bus, whether you're traveling on the train, anything to a fabric. It is a likelihood that you're going to pick up bed bugs from somewhere. It's happening all over the country, all over the world. And so there's no denying it, and there's no being immune to it regardless of what your status is financially. And you don't want to be ignorant about these things. Another thing is, again, teach your kids when they come home, do not take their garments, throw it on the floor, book bags. And even if they have other kids visiting, you don't know how many houses we've visited in which people got bed bugs from other people. Now, I'm saying you can't, not that you can't have people in your house, but you got to use common sense. There was one house that we visited in Piscataway, New Jersey, about a year and a half ago or so, and the girl who was 13 years old had a friend sleep over, and when the friend slept over, she opened up her bag to take her garments out, and the girl said to her mommy, "Look, mommy, my friend had a bug crawling out of her bag." It ended up being bed bugs. Her whole house became infested. So until next time, I'm Scott, you're not. Hopefully you got some great information that you can utilize. Stay posted. Visit my www.getmyfreebedbugreport.com. I want to give you some latest and greatest information. And also stay posted to our videos at bitebackthosebedbugs.com. This is useful information that we're always happy to share with you. If you live in the New Jersey or Central New Jersey area and you're looking to have a bed bug treatment, feel free to reach out to my office. The number is, I think I have it on here, it's 1-855-BUG-BITE. So give us a call. We're happy to help you. We specialize in heat. We have more heat than anybody in a tri-state area. We have freezing. We have chemical. We have steam. We have whatever you need when it comes to bed bugs. I'm an expert in it, and I can definitely help you or guide you in the right direction. What you don't want to do is start picking up the store-bought products and just spraying all over the place and think you're doing a great job. Another thing you don't want to do is you don't want to pick up products that are marked for fleas or ticks. You don't want to set off bug bombs. You want to use the right products to get the right job done. Until next time, stay tuned at www.getmyfreebedbugreport.com, and I'll catch you soon. Enjoy the snow. Bye.